Dear students, today we learn about internet and IT concepts. So, what is internet? Internet is a large collection of network. In other words, we can say that internet is network of network. And internet originates in United States of America, where it is used for military purposes. An electronic military organization called DOD, Department of Defense, where they initiate a project called ARPANET, means Advanced Research Project Agency Network. And the initial time, internet is used for basically sending confidential information from one office to another office. So internet is a network of network in today's concern. But initial, it is originally used at United States. And internet affects our life much, where without internet, we can't imagine our daily life. So, internet revolutionizes the whole world. Now, the next term is search engine. So, what is search engine? A search engine is a software usually accessed on the internet, and the search is a database of information according to the user's query. The engine provides a list of results that best matches what the user is trying to find. So, we can say that search engine is just like a software, and if we want to search any information on net, on internet, then you can type on the search engine, and the search engine searches from the net and display the result. One of the famous search engine is Google, and I think you all are aware of it. Whenever you have to find any information, you just go on to Google and type it, and the Google displays the desired result. And another very famous search engine is YouTube. It is a video search engine, and whenever you want to any educational videos, music, songs, you can find it on YouTube. Our next topic is web browser. A web browser is application software that allows us to view and explore information on the web. User can request for any web page by just entering a URL into address bar. So, we can say that a web browser is a client software where we can type the URL of any site, and without web browser, it is not possible to view web pages. But actually, in the initial times, there are some console types where we can find our desired information. Examples of web browser is Internet Explorer, Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, Opera, and Safari. And Google Chrome and Firefox, Mozilla Firefox are very famous web browsers. Our next topic is Uniform Resource Locator, URL. So, URL is known as Uniform Resource Locator, is the address of a resource on the internet and the protocol used to access it. So, whenever you want to access any site, you just type http://www.google.com. So this is a example of URL. Now we learn about internet services. Internet services allows us to access huge amount of information such as text, graphics, sound and software over the internet. So our first internet service is electronic mail, which is a very famous, and I think you all are using it. Electronic mail means email is used to send electronic messages over the internet. We will discuss in detail in the later our subsequent topics. Next is Telnet. What is Telnet? Telnet is used to log on to a remote computer that is attached to internet. Newsgroup. Newsgroup offers a forum for people to discuss topics of common interest. IRC, Internet Relay Chat, allows the people from all over the world to communicate in real time. Mailing lists used to organize group of internet users to share common information through email. And one of the famous topic is internet telephony. We say that VOIP, voice over internet protocol. Internet telephony allows the internet users to talk across internet to any PC equipped to receive the calls. This means that just like we can make a call to our mobile phone, so instead of using mobile phones, we can use our laptop, tablets and PCs to make a call. IM, instant messaging. Instant messaging offers real-time chat between individual and group of people. That is Yahoo Messenger. In earlier time it is a famous messenger, but in the current days there are a lot of instant messaging, just like a WhatsApp chat. There are a lot of our next topic is www. It is also called W3. www is also known as W3. It offers a way to access documents spread over the several servers over the internet. So here the word comes, server. So what do you mean by server? Here server means to serve. Server is a machine that serves its clients. So these documents may contain text, graphics, audio, video, hyperlinks. The hyperlinks allow the users to navigate between the documents. Our next topic is web server. So what is a web server? Now just we talked about server. A web server is just like a machine that provide its services. Web server is a computer where the web content is stored. Basically, web server is used to host the web sites, but there exists over the web servers also, such as gaming, storage, FTP, email, etc. One of the famous electronic mail you are using is Gmail. So where your mails are stored? Whenever you open your mobile or PC or laptop, whenever you type user ID and password, all your earlier mails are present there. Actually, it is stored on Gmail's web server, and there, and whenever you want to check your mails, you can just log into your system and you check your mails. So these mails are actually stored on the their Gmail's Google's web server, and they are working 24 hours. Example of web server are Apache HTTP server, Internet Information Services, IIS. These are the two very famous web servers. Our next topic is firewall. So what is a firewall? A firewall is a software used to maintain the security of private network. Firewalls block unauthorized access to or from private networks and are often employed to prevent unauthorized web users to illicit software from gaining access to private networks connected to the internet. Means firewall secures your network and it restricts unauthorized access to your system. Our next topic is Internet Service Provider. So I think you all are using mobile phones. So what is ISP? An ISP is an organization or company that provides services for accessing, using or participating in the internet. Suppose you are using a Jio mobile and you are using a Jio SIM, then Jio is your Reliance, Jio is your ISP. If you are using an Airtel, then and using your internet through Airtel mobile, then your ISP is Airtel. Our next topic is Hypertext Transfer Protocol, HTTP. So HTTP is the set of rules for transferring files such as text, graphic, images, sound, video and other multimedia files on the World Wide Web. So it is a protocol, and the question arises, what is a protocol? A protocol is a set of rules. So HTTP is a set of rules for transferring text, graphic, images, sound, video files. TCP/IP, Transmission Control Protocol, Internet Protocol. TCP/IP, it is also a protocol which is a set of networking protocols that allows two or more computers to communicate. So these are the basic concepts about IT and internet. So that's all for the today. Thank you.